Hey friends, Dave here with Transfer Express, and today we are talking about the easiest way to design t-shirts without any graphic design software, experience, or training. That's right, we're talking about using customizable easy prints artwork in the free EasyView Online Designer. There's no need to buy artwork from those expensive SVG catalogs online, pay those expensive monthly subscriptions for Adobe Creative Cloud, or learn Illustrator or Corel Draw. EasyView gives you everything you need to create print-ready artwork free, fast, and of course, easy. Now today, we're going to walk through the process together step by step of customizing professional, retail-ready artwork for absolutely free, and it's just gonna take us a couple minutes. All you need is your computer. So are you ready? Let's get to customizing. If you are new to Transfer Express, we are the world's largest supplier of custom screen printed and digital heat transfers, heat presses, free customizable designs, wholesale apparel, and expert advice to help grow your t-shirt business. If you haven't already, subscribe. We're kicking out new videos like this one every single week. Now that we've got our computer here, fired up, ready to go, and connected to a reliable internet connection, let's head on over to transferexpress.com to get started. Now here you could design your custom t-shirt graphics online in our free, robust EasyView Online Designer. Even if you have zero graphic design experience, there's over 10,000 customizable layouts and clip art that you could use for free. Now creating an account is quick and easy, and you don't even need to enter a credit card number. And we're even gonna send you some goodies like this welcome pack after you get signed up. Now this includes a black and white version of our one and only idea book. Now the idea book has our most popular layouts and clip arts available in the EasyView Designer. And of course, everything in this book is 100% customizable. All you need to do is type in the code that corresponds to the design in the search bar at the top of our designer right here, and in seconds, you could pull up a scaled version of the artwork from the book and start customizing. But now that we're here in EasyView, let's begin by bringing in a layout. Now we're looking to make a souvenir merch t-shirt for one of our state parks here in Ohio. For a timeless outdoor themed design with that retro look, the layout here, QMS 210, is a popular choice. You could search for the artwork by keyword, category, or exact layout number by using that add layout button right here on the left-hand side of the designer in the blue bar. Now the first edit we're gonna have to make is the text. Double-clicking on the text in the online designer, we could update the text to say Salt Fork, Ohio, instead of the Compton placeholder copy. So just double-clicking on each of these allows you to change that. In addition to changing the contents of our text, we could also change the font too. We could click on the text once just to select it, as indicated by the green dotted line or bounding box. And once our text is selected, we could navigate over to our edit panel here on the left-hand side of our designer and click font. From there, we could scroll through this huge selection of fonts and replace this red zone font that we're using right now with something that fits our fancy. Now, after we've selected a font, we could also adjust the outline surrounding the text too, if we want to make it thicker or thinner. I'm going to make sure the text is selected, and then I'll navigate to the bottom of this edit menu to the outline setting in this tab. And you could see that we already have one applied, but going to the edit menu even further by clicking on outline, I could adjust the size by using the plus and minus buttons right here at the top. Now keep in mind that our minimum line thickness for screen prints is 0.012 inches, or about 1 point. So you could always verify that your lines are thick enough to print by using our measurement tool that's available right here in the designer. We just put together a whole video on how to utilize this brand new helpful tool if you do need it, and we'll link that one right here in the video and also in the description below. Now that our text is looking great, the second step is going to be finding a replacement for the mountains. Now here in Ohio, we don't necessarily have mountains, maybe more like rolling hills. So these huge rocky peaks that are in this clip art are not going to work for us right here. So let's just swap them out. All we have to do is click on the mountains and the trees to select them and delete them using the key on your keyboard or the trash can icon at the top of the designer. One thing to keep in mind is some layouts are grouped together. So if the layout is grouped together and you can't select individual elements, just click on the layout to select it, go up to our blue bar at the top, and use the drop-down menu here for object and just click ungroup. Next, we're gonna search for some new mountains that are gonna suit our park a little bit better, those rolling hills. So we're gonna go to the left-hand side and click add Clipart instead of add layout this time. Now with just a simple search with our keyword as mountain, I don't know what we'll get from rolling hills, and we'll find a nice replacement. But as you can see here, Clipart X12C80 has a great rolling hill look to it. So we're gonna select it. And with just a click, it's added to our artboard. Now these new mountains look great and exactly what we're looking for, but our park, say, doesn't have a lake like this new Clipart does. So let's remove it. With the Clipart selected, we could ungroup it by clicking on object in the top blue bar and clicking ungroup. Once it's ungrouped, we could click on the water shapes and just delete them. Next, we could arrange our Clipart above our text and even slide the cattail elements here over to the right-hand side, separating them from our rolling hills. Using the arrange tool at the top blue bar, we could bring the Clipart to the top so it sits on top of all of our other elements. Now, once we're happy with this design, it's time to move on to colors. First, we could change the color of our background to match the garments we're going to be printing on. So we'll go down here to the bottom left and click on apparel color, this little square, and change it to our garment color. Once we have our garment color set, let's finalize our ink colors by navigating up to that black square in the edit tab. And for these shirts, I think a simple white ink is going to look best. So we're just gonna select white from the menu here and bam, now all of our inks have changed over to white. And now we have a fully customized print ready design that we made for free and in just a few minutes. No need for a super high powered computer or anything. Now, once we are done designing, we could actually use the EasyView's mockup feature over here on the left hand side, and we could import a picture that we took of our crew neck sweatshirt and then place our design on it and download the image as a social media post or a product photo. Or even a proof that we could send to our customer. Now we have a whole video on how to use this mockup feature that we'll link right here and also down in the description below. But as you could see, these mockups are going to help you close those sales, and people love seeing their ideas come to life on a finished t-shirt. This costs you nothing. You don't have to buy any blanks or any sample transfers to get this photo. I hope you feel empowered and inspired now to customize your own artwork. It is truly this simple. Make sure you subscribe right here to our YouTube for tons of helpful tips and tricks just like this one. We're dropping new videos every single week and we're releasing a whole series on EasyView features. But until next time, I'm Dave. Happy pressing.